friends. It's really good to get a chance to be with you guys. Thank you very much for just having this time together to share. I appreciate that. For reasons I don't understand or can't explain, God has placed Africa in my heart. My month-long trip was 30 years in the making, and I went with high expectations and no expectations. What I knew about Africa came from what I'd seen on TV, read on the internet, and in magazines, and heard from people who had been there personally. All of the information was right on, and as far off as it could possibly be. I never, ever could have imagined in my wildest dreams the incredible contrast I was in for when I went to Kenya. Mile after mile, I saw vast beauty and endless poverty. I felt incredible peace and troubling distress. At times, I had to close my eyes for a bit to allow my mind and my heart to process the extremes that I was taking in. People walking in the middle of nowhere in dress clothes and rags, some carrying very heavy water jugs, others carrying supplies of some sort, people sleeping on the side of the roads and walking long distances, shacks made of mud and sticks and pieces of this and that, little children walking everywhere and often without any kind of adult supervision, acres of beautiful tea fields and corn growing everywhere, hillsides of rich red dirt, farmers with machetes during the day, and policemen with machine guns at night. I was there working with local missionaries from Christ Hope International, one of our mission partners here at Christ Community. The first 2 weeks of my trip, I spent most of my time in schools, orphanages, and children's prisons, teaching children of all ages about Christ-centered sexual purity, a program called Choose to Wait. I also taught adults in AIDS support groups. AIDS is widespread in Kenya, and everyone is touched by it in some way. I was in an area of Kenya where there is mass poverty and oppression. So when I say orphanage or school or prison, they're nothing like what they are here in the U.S. Think of stables for animals, and you'll have a better picture of what they're like. By our standards, these places aren't conceivable or acceptable in any way as places for children. I always began my talk by telling them that I had saved my money and traveled on a plane a very long way because I wanted to see someone that was very special, and that I had a message for this person that was very important from God. The children would always respond, Who is it? Who is it? And they'd look around at each other and want to know who this very special person was. I'd tell them the message is that God loves this person very much. And this very important person that I've come all this way to see is you. You are special. You are valuable. And God loves you very much. All of them would light up with beautiful faces and bright eyes and breathtaking smiles shining right through the scars and the burns, the disease, the thin bones, the bloated bellies, and the bare feet. Children feeling valued and maybe for the first time being told that someone loves them. The second 2 weeks of my trip, I spent caring for people in hospitals for the poor and in their mud huts and hovels. I'm thankful for the experience I had on the first half of my trip, and yet after my first day at the hospital, I realized that I had experienced only a surface glimpse of the pain and suffering that existed in this place. The hospital was tough, more than tough, beyond words, beyond description. The treatment of the patients was heartbreaking. Those who were there would rarely get much food or water or be bathed or have their clothes changed or have their sheets changed. They just laid there, two to a bed, heads next to feet. There were cockroaches, ants, and it reeked of urine. People dying, people in comas, almost all of them terminal, and most left to die alone. The words care and compassion take on new meaning in a place like this. So I would caress their thin bones and share the message of hope in Jesus Christ with them, pray with them, and remind them that they are valuable, they are loved, and that God knows every hair on their head. They are not forgotten, and most important, they are never alone. I shared scripture with them, and they looked me right in the eyes, deep into my eyes. It was like our souls were talking to each other. So many faces are in my head and in my heart. Even now, they revisit me when I lay down at night to go to sleep. Scripture memorized has never been more meaningful to me than in this place. When I shared the promises in God's word, there was a peace that came that truly surpassed understanding. It was as though at that very moment, time stood still and the pain and suffering of this world fell away. And God's grace and mercy and truth and light shined in an indescribable way. Beauty in the midst of despair. Hope and light in the midst of such darkness. I experienced tears of sadness and peace of heart all at the very same time. I am filled with a joy that I cannot explain. God is good and God is faithful. I left Africa with a thankful heart, thankful to God that He had called me there and that He had stayed with me the entire time. He drew me even closer to Himself than I ever knew could be possible. I am thankful for very small things, a smile, a kindness, food, a flower. I'm thankful for being taught by the Christ Hope missionaries how to love and to give beyond my means. They share the very little they have to help others. I am thankful for the blessings of God's beauty and the peace and the strength that He gives in the midst of unimaginable suffering. People ask me, given all you've seen and experienced, would you go back? Given all I've seen and experienced, I can't imagine not going back.